Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Build, episode 6. In the previous episode, I had done the fascia of this train station, and now I'm going around and I'm doing all the sides and the back and the roof and all of that, so we have a final completed building. So what I'm basically doing is I'm going around, at this point I'm just testing out sizes. Actually, this is way too large. As you can see, I make it a bit smaller now as I go through, only having it two windows at the back. What I'm basically doing is I'm going around and I'm repeating the exact same design that I've done all the way around. But one thing that I'm not doing, which is what I did on the front, was where I made the white frames around the windows on the bottom floor, I decided to go against that and just do something different, which you will see later on in the video, which is just a very basic panel on the bottom of the windowsill thing. So we're going around and I'm doing both floors. Here's the second floor coming in. Again, it's all the same design all the way around. One thing that I did do though, as you can see on the back, is I've made it only the first floor. I didn't want to have this massive second floor that I had nothing to do with. I'm still thinking about what I want to do with that second floor, but I'm thinking about using it to make a like a little Burger King, or maybe a coffee shop or something. I don't really know, but you know, it's one of those sort of things that you would find inside of a train station. And then I've got this bottom bit that I'm doing. I'm having a glass window because it was quite a large area to not have much light in the middle. I know I don't really have that in the main part of the building, but it was a good opportunity for me to have a glass roof. Again, this is actually part of the design that I used in the previous original version of this build. Most of this is as it is in the original, including the shape and the size, really. I was trying at the start to make it different, but I realized that, you know, as I had it before was best, as clearly I'd done the same in the past and came to the same conclusion. So now I'm going around and doing the arduous task of doing all the designs on all of the windows. I've got to say, this is definitely the downside to building with microblocks, is it's just, there's quite a lot of time done on much smaller areas than you would be doing, you know, spending that same amount of time building in something in vanilla Minecraft, for example. So I'm going around using the same things, you can see, it's just the same design. This is slightly different on the bottom here because it's two wide at the top rather than just one wide that you would have on the rest of the windows. But it was basically very simple to repeat that pattern again. And then I'm going around and I'm just making a nice little border with concrete, just so I've got a little path going around. I'm actually going to be playing around with that because I'm going to be adding car parks, I'm going to be adding gardens and all this sort of stuff to the build. So that may change, it all may differ at some point, which is actually quite likely, I imagine, because this is one build where I've tried to change it up from what I had before, trying to make nice little changes and perhaps modernizations. Now that I'm using Forge Multipart, for example, instead of the microblocks that you would have found in Red Power that I used before, there's actually more that you can do inside this one, so there were certain design things that I could do this time that I couldn't have done before. Now, one thing you can see that I'm doing on the roof there with those bits of wood, they are actually part of the Carpenter's Blocks mod, and they are slopes. Now, on this view here, there is for some reason no side view on the slopes from the computer that shoots all of this stuff. But when I build on my other computer, I can see the side, so I'm not quite sure where that bug is coming from. But there we go. I may actually change that at some point, but for now, the gap is so small that it doesn't really matter, and it just makes it a bit different because I'm using a different mod and I'm not just using Forge Multipart. I'm actually using Carpenter's Blocks and using the slopes and all that sort of stuff. So I've gone around and I've made basically the ceiling solid rather than just having a panel on top, which is what I'm doing here. So I made sure that I have the thick blocks on top and only the panels on this bit here. It's basically meant to be like a, I think it's called bitumen, and it's meant to be like a bitumen surface on the roof. But that is actually it for this video. This is now showing you how it looks now as a full building. And in the next episode, I'm going to be going around and hopefully I'm going to be making a big fencing around it, or a wall, or hedges. I don't know what I'm going to be doing yet. And I've actually, if you haven't noticed yet, I have moved this place. You may notice that. It's actually in a completely different area to what it was before, because before it was next to my other build. Now I've placed it in its own area, which is why I'm now going to have that as its own area that I'm going to fence off, and it's going to have the car park, it's going to have the gardens, it's going to have the train tracks, the train station, the platform, all of that sort of stuff is going to be there in this build. But that is actually it for this video. It's very hard doing these because you never know. This, I think this was about maybe 2 or 3 hours plus building, maybe more. It's very hard to know how much building is going to equate to one video once I've edited it and cut it down and done the voiceovers over the top. So sometimes they may be longer or shorter than others, but I think this actually works out perhaps the same time as last time. So I think we're doing well. We're doing okay. But we're doing a lot better than before, where I had like 12 minutes and I just talked for way too long. No one cares about half the stuff that I'm talking about, I imagine. You just want to see the cool, awesome build. But there you have it. The bulk of the exterior of the train station is now complete, and we can move on to the interior and doing all the grounds and, of course, the train station, the platform and everything. But that's going to be it for this video. If you've enjoyed this video, please let me know by rating, commenting and subscribing. And don't forget to share it to your friends and let everyone know that this series exists. That would be awesome. So until next time, thank you guys very much for watching, and goodbye!